Hello friends, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video we will cover libraries, like from where we need to pick the load. Now let's see the agenda. We can have libraries at job level, then we can have at step level, then we can have at JCL level, and then the include statement. So we'll first start with job level. So here at job level we can mention, and we can mention the location where our program load is present. So it will be at the job level. Whenever a step is trying to find a program and it is not there, then it will go to the job level and it will search in this library. The syntax is simple. You need to mention job lib. This is the keyword. Then you need to mention the DD statement, DSN. This is data definition. Then here you need to data set name. The full form of DSN is data set name, and you need to mention the data set name here. The data set where our loads are present. It's a PDS. Then disposition is share. This part we will be covering in the DD statements. And disposition share means open the PDS in the share mode. Now similarly we have step lib. So previously here you have mentioned at the job level. Suppose if you have a program and you know the its location where it is present, then you can mention that in at the step level itself. So this will be applicable only to that step. It will not be applicable to other steps. So here the syntax is step lib and DD. Same syntax, DSN name, then disp is equal to disposition, that is share, and it should be specified after the exec statement and before the DD statement of the job step. Next we have JCL lib. This one is for procedures. Suppose you have coded one catalog procedure, so that procedure will be present in some library. So for that you need to code the JCL lib. If you are using procedures, then only you need to code JCL lib. So the syntax is name, then the keyword JCL lib. Then order, in order you need to mention the name of PDS where your catalog procedure is present, and it should be just after the job statement. No statement should be present between the job statement and the JCL lib. So then we have include. Suppose you are having a module and you need to write it every time, like you have a block of lines that needs to be there in all the programs or in all the JCLs, then you need to write it again and again in the JCL. So in JCL we have an option. What you can do is, in one of the member you can code that line. Suppose we'll talk about the job card. In the job card you can see we have all the statements that are almost same. So if you want to use that parameters, they can use include statement. So what include does is, when it is submitted, it just copy from that include member and it paste in our main JCL. So this is how we are using one member and we are copying it into many different modules. We are using it there. So this is the syntax, name, include member, and here you need to mention the member name where our member is present. So now let's see all these functions practically.
We will see the use of base libraries. Open the PDS. I've created one member library in which I have used different type of libraries. Base libraries are PDS which holds the load modules of the program to be executed in the JCL or the catalog procedure which is called in the program. We'll start with JCL lib. JCL lib must be coded just after the job statement. So the syntax is, here you need to give any name, then the keyword JCL lib. Then here you need to mention the PDS where your procedure is present. It is used for catalog procedures. So here I am calling a procedure proc1. So in step 3 it will go to the JCL lib PDS here, and in this PDS it will search for proc1. Then we have job lib. So syntax is, first you need to mention job lib, then DD, DSN. Here you need to mention the PDS name, and disposition is equal to share. So we'll cover more about DSN and disp in the next video. So in short, DSN is data set name. And disposition is equal to share means we are opening it in share mode. Job lib statement is used in order to identify the location of the program to be executed in JCL. So in step 2 you can see the program 2. We have not mentioned any step lib, so it will go to the job lib here, tutorial.point.load, and it will search the load in this PDS. Job lib is given at the job level. First of all, the program will be searched in this PDS. Then we have step lib. Suppose along with job lib you have mentioned step lib also. So your program will be searched in this library. So it is used to identify the location of program to be executed at the step level. Then we have include statement. It is a set of JCL statements coded within a member of PDS, and it can be included to a JCL using the include statement. So give any name here, then include, this is the keyword. You need to mention the member here. It will go to this PDS and it will copy all the statements present in INC1 module in this member basically, and it will paste it here. The JES interprets the JCL, and the set of JCL statements within the include member replaces the include statement. So this is all about libraries. In the next video, we'll start with DD statement.